So Manhattanhenge is really just like a, it happens because of the geometry of the city. The sun as it sets gets aligned with the east-west direction of the New York grid. So I work with computer graphics and I'm very interested in how the geometry of the city actually impacts its physical properties. I was interested to study how shadows in the city impact, you know, where people walk, how they feel. So one of the things that actually is quite striking is how light changes from summer to winter. You know, people tend to actually walk in different corners of the street depending on whether you're like in summer or winter. The reason Manhattanhenge happens twice is that the grid of Manhattan is not aligned with the east-west. You see it as it hits the extrema and as it comes back. The buildings that affect the shadows the most, or how dark it is, they actually tend to be the ones that are the more like wider types of buildings than the really super tall ones. But when you really think about it, like the shadows over them as the sun changes move so fast, right, that a lot of times they don't really have such a negative effect on sunlight. I think that the best ways to view Manhattanhenge is actually on the broader streets. So for instance, I actually really like it on 14th Street, right? And you probably don't want to get all the way to the Hudson. You probably want to maybe be on 7th Avenue or the middle of between 6th and 7th. And it's really striking to see it as the sun goes down.